What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Madden Ultimate Team. Got some solo battles, which I think we're going to take care of now. The Bears and the Raiders. Let's go better.
Hey everybody, it's the coach. Welcome you to another installment of Madden Ultimate Team. There's been a lot of talk leading up to this matchup, and it's finally here. But can it live up to all the hype?
And we are underway at Allegiant Stadium. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And they're going to start this drive.
They got special shape
as they get it up past the 30.
Those are cool.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Right to the air is Carr. Catch is made by
by three guys.
Right on the chalk of the 45. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs.
Wow.
And some room. And now look at this. Big game.
I'll take it.
Scooped up by the Jets. Well, he's going to have to shake out the cobwebs. First time he touches the football.
So many times we talk about quarterbacks and taking care of them early to get them in the flow with safe throws, right? But with a runner, there is no such thing as a safe run, right? And right out of the gate, you're going to be in some traffic. Got to take care of the ball, and he didn't do that.
Good gain on first, has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Carhart
to throw his Fields. Open man is Samuel, complete. Gets past one
nice.
Man. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially as pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams get good pass rushing teams.
Zach Bird.
Justin Jefferson, 35 yards. And the Jets are on the board first here in Vegas. The Charles here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. Designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. Now at the line, ready for their next drive. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it.
Ball security.
The National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. Now Carr.
Oh.
Coverage and it's intercepted. The Jets are going to take possession here at their own 33.
Man, I'm not going to tell him that you called him older than our pregame meeting, but this guy has been around a long time. If there's a trick in the book, he knows it. He probably even wrote a few chapters, and this is what he's always had, and that's a nose for the football. He's able to come away here with the interception.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12.
There we go.
And he'll be tackled just past the 35 and the 36. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a third and about 7 left.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. Pretty decent game.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. He's got a man. Complete.
There we go. Let's go, baby.
Jets lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Well, they went play action there and set it up nicely for him. I mean, he can flat fly, and they hit him downfield.
All right.
And it doesn't take much to create that extra bit of space that a guy of his speed needs. If you go play action, all you want is just a moment where the guy's covering, take their attention somewhere else, and then he's by him. And once he's by him, there's no catch. As they always like to say, if a receiver's even to a defensive back, that means he's leaving.
Unless that DB is Charles Davis, right?
In that case, he left me a long time ago.
Come on.
Trust me.
It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic Oath. First, do no harm. But right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. Now, Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10.
Oh.
This throw is going to be incomplete.
The completions at first and second down, it certainly seems like a punch. We've seen some hard in this game. The defense took her to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on third down.
Throwing his car on third down. And this one is incomplete.
Well, based on what we've seen so far, I don't think you can even call this an off day anymore, partner, because this group we're watching, they are totally out of rhythm trying to get their game plan up and running. That zero on the scoreboard is clearing down at them with every incompletion.
51 yards on the punt there. And the Jets offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. On first down, Fields. Dancing to his left. And Fields got the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. He got 29 yards that time. On first down, it's Fields.
Go!
It's caught inside the 25.
Oh, my God.
Touchdown. Debo Samuel, 57 yards. And the Jets are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Well, just a sensational start for this offense, Charles. Three drives, three passing touchdowns.
Is that like mentioning the perfect game of baseball? Are we cool to do it here in football, partner?
No, I think you can do it here in football. That perfect game in baseball, that's its own category.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. Could not imagine a worse start for that secondary. But let's face it, a better one for this offense. No chance to stop passing now the way that it's going. I think we'll continue to press the ball downfield and hopefully reap the same results.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category.
Oh, there we go.
Points category. Let's see if they can do better here at this point. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. throw again on second down. Carr, and he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing now is Carr. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now to punt this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 18-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Jets will take over.
How many yards do you have already? 300? 182? Oh, I'm only in the first. Feels way more than that.
Here's Fields. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. And now it's Fields. Lines up and lets it go for Samuel. That's caught inside the 20. Now all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Debo Samuel. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Jets are able to add on to their first half lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And it is 28-0. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tiny two-play drive that time. Five tutties. Oh my. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The offense back out there at the line ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack at second and 20. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. They'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter.
There's going to kneel, aren't they?
Yep.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee and
all right.
Do it for half number one. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Taking it about the one. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. On first and 10,
oh my
it's
God.
Fields taking a shot for Samuel. That's caught at the 25. And on the right end, touchdown. Debo Samuel, 73 yards. And the Jets come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that. Truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Extra point right down the middle, and it is 42-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they battled up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. On second down, Jacobs. And he'll grab a gain of five out of this up to the 41-yard line. We're just looking at the scoreboard and where we're at in the third quarter. I don't know that it's going to matter much at this point, CD, but these small runs on the ground, they're not going to get it done.
Oh.
No, they're not, and right now,
and the Jets are going to get the football here at their own 23. And I guess we're at the point of the game where they do need to open up the playbook a little bit, start to take some chances down the field, but that one did not go as planned.
Yeah, these guys need something good to go there.
Come on, go.
And now off to the races, down the right side.
There we go.
And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Curtis Samuel, 77 yards. And the Jets just continue to roll. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win has probably gone out the window, Charles. But I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
Card out of throw. Catch made.
He's short. Oh.
He'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. Again, it's Carr. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Just what they need, a lecture from me, but subpar offense is what helped get them into this spot. And now they're continuing the trend with incompletions. That won't get them out of it if they don't change something soon.
Off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Now Carr.
There we go.
As he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And New York set to take the field. Now a first down throw, Fields. That's going to be caught by Moss. And he'll take this to the outside of midfield before going out of bounds. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31. Fields on first down. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Debo Samuel. 49 yards, and the Jets get another third-quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. On the other sideline right now, it's just absolute dejection. But, Charles, let's focus on the positive. With the lead that they've built here, they've done pretty much everything to perfection in this ball game.
They certainly have. Makes me think that their week of preparation was excellent, and they flowed into this game, and it carried over.
Team out now to boot this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. The disparity in this game, it just seems to grow with each possession here, Charles. They are really struggling. And he loses
there it is again.
A second time, and it's scooped up by the Jets. Set up shop at the 33-yard line. And a little careless there, Charles, on that carry.
It's not just having two hands on the ball. It's tucking it away. It's using your body to keep people shielded off. There's so many different things into taking care of it and having ball security. In that case, though, we didn't see it happen.
Touchdown, Jets! Randy Moss, 33 yards. And the Jets are able to extend their lead. Seconds of this third quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. They certainly made quick work of that, ultra quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see, just one play resulting in the touchdown. The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And solid field position here to start as they get this out to the 40-yard line.
Where's he at now? 539.
Use the word.
8 tutties. Unbelievable.
It has to start right here, right now. That return just set him up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers, they've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball. And it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
Looking to throw on second down. Carr throwing middle, and it's complete. Get it down on the other side of midfield. Carr now on first down.
Oh.
It's intercepted.
I totally did that.
Oh, definitely me. That penalty wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You gotta face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you and your squad.
Throw left side, take it in by Renfro. And not much happening there. He's taking
Come on.
A penalty flag in the backfield.
That I don't agree with. I wasn't even near it.
Well, Charles, sometimes we talk about the lengths officials sometimes go to protect star quarterbacks, but that one, that was tough to argue against.
Yeah, and I'm sure that everyone's going to say, hey, we're going to administer the penalty the same way for all quarterbacks. But when it's a star back there,
another flag.
But now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about.
You gotta be kidding me.
And that flag accepted. So now then the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. Working from the gun, it's Carr. The quick slant, Carr. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
And as a quarterback, you're always pleased when you can use all the weapons at your disposal. Here he spots his fullback underneath, gets the completion right there for a nice pickup.
Back in the end zone, could he get his feet? No, it's incomplete. Another shot to at least get on the board here. This is third and goal. Here's Carr to throw.
Nope.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
And his kick
finally
is good.
Jesus.
And he'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit.
That drive is ridiculous.
Well, it's a Pyrrhic victory at best, but Charles, no team wants to get shut out, so it's hard to blame him for taking the three there.
You can't blame him one bit. It hasn't been the best performance, that's for darn sure. But there is something to be said for fighting to avoid the goose egg, and they're at least trying to finish out strong.
Here comes Randy Moss and company as they take the field. Now this defense, they wouldn't mind not seeing him again for a while. Three trips to the end zone, how about that?
I think right now, they would happily go to their general manager and say, is there any way you can get a trade for him? Bring him over to our team so we don't have to cover him anymore? Because he is really having a heck of a ball game, isn't it?
Boy, he is. I don't know that mid-game trade's going to happen, but good thought.
That's a tutty. There we go.
Six, it's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. Not much, and now it appears that the referee's been...
Oh, come on.
...review on this game inside 2 minutes of play. Everything coming from up above. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
Yeah, okay, we're good.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point right down the middle. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. It's a squib kick picked up near the 25. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line.
And with that kind of a... This would be number 10, right? Yeah, so I guess this would be number 10.
He can't afford to make any kind of mistakes, but it's been pretty symptomatic with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Charles, they're still airing it out at this point despite that huge lead, and some people may be saying, well, why are they throwing the football? These guys, I guess, are just padding their step. And this will be caught, and the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Coaches come into a game preaching total team effort, CD. I think this is the type of ball game that they're dreaming of. It was pretty apparent early on that they were clicking in all three phases. It's been fun to watch.
Yeah, sometimes in the NFL, you end up with matchups like we've been watching here. And when you go back to the early drives, you can just see that one squad was on a different level in this game. Safe to say, we have been disappointed watching their execution.
Oh my God. He's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded it.
Huge on the scoreboard, and they're still trying to add to their total. That shot doesn't connect, but I don't think it'll dissuade them from attempting another one.
Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he takes it
nice.
For the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome. Cream on top to their ending.
As our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lanyard, a little extra on top.
Well, when they said before the game that they were going to try and execute everything,
they're not going to let us kick the extra point. 11 tutties. Wait, 1 minute. We did good. There's one where it's like, he like 300 passing yards or something like that. Oh, the fumbles were close. The yards, that's what it was. Oh wow, look at all that. We could get all that pretty quick. This next game, we just rush. Thank you. We could really cheat it and go on rookie. I just rushed the whole time.
I like those old Bear jerseys. Those are nice. Whoa, it's like we sequenced it. In that passing game?
Second and eight coming up. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the right place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now Brown on third down.
Okay.
And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. And now that they've coughed it up, you gotta go back to the sidelines and regroup a little.
Whoa, hey, big guy.
And he's got room.
There we go.
Curtis Samuel. Guys have taken a first quarter lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. I'm not sure if they drew that play up to score, but it scored indeed. One play on the ground and into the end zone for six. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. Start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Right now they're on the wrong end of the scoreboard, and that won't change if this drive ends like the last one when they had that lost fumble. So you have a feeling taking care of the football certainly paramount right now.
Yeah, it's not just the guy who dropped it on the last drive, is it? That means everyone who might touch the ball is getting the same message. Guys, ball security paramount. Let's take care of it. If we do, we got a chance to pick.
Oh, nice catch.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 22 yards there. First down.
That was triple team.
Up the middle they go with a big back, Jackson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Okay, that's interesting.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Go. Oh, he's tired. He was so tired.
Curtis Samuel on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. As his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now 21 to nothing. The drive summary that time, five plays. And the last play, a really nice run that culminated in the touchdown. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively.
He caught that? Wow. Two crazy catches by this team.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw. Brown. And dump this to Brown. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. A final shot before break.
Flag.
Looking for the out route. He's got it. Complete to Kittle. And head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9.
That's nonsense.
That flag puts him on their heels a little bit more defensively as the officials walk it upfield.
Yeah, they can blame the officials all they want, but bottom line, it's their own fault because to me, that was an avoidable call. Stay focused and avoid mistakes like that.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis on Brandon Gaughton getting set for quarter number 3 here. Takes it at the 7. And he's going to be out of bounds here on the return at his own 2-yard line.
Only able to get it to the 2-yard line on his return. Not going to make a lot of friends on your team when you only get it that far.
They'll start this drive out on the ground.
Oh, wow.
And he's got some space here. He's at the 50. The 30. 10. 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Curtis Samuel, 98 yards. As his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. Point after, right down the middle. And they open the lead up now to 25. The offensive coordinators dream about one play drives from that distance. What an effort! It results in the touchdown. Kicks it on the ground with a squib, taken around the 28. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, right past the 30. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. The CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. That's try to come back from a 4-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl.
Fumble.
It's going the other way.
Let's go.
And they're going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Do you remember in preseason when we went to the different training camps and visiting teams, and we always would see the running backs working out and going through those gauntlet drills, yep. And, you know, guys either slapping in the ball or the machines. You got to learn to take care of it.
Yeah, they lost eek. It there, big fumble.
Solid eek. Okay.
And brought down, but able to get it to the 30-yard line. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in for second half blowout material.
Ah, damn it.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. A handoff for Samuel. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Curtis Samuel, 28 yards. And the fumble recovery leads to 6 points. extra point splits the uprights, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Scoring summary, three-play drive, and a pretty good run there in the end to top it off. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Very short kick. This
one out of him. Oh, God, again.
And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
As that ball got away from him, and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things you hear all week in practice.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Curtis Samuel, 27 yards, as his guys continue to pour it on. Extra point right down the middle, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Well, they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Kicks it on the ground with a squib, taken around the 28. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Offense ready to go for their next drive. And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of it.
Oh.
He wants the football, and this is picked up by the defense.
The new running backs in the backfield to help pass protect. All the receivers in their patterns. It's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case,
there we go.
Touchdown! Curtis Samuel, 35 yards. And the fumble recovery leads to 6 points. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper. Into the end zone for the touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And here we are almost through three quarters of play in this passing game, so it's not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
And it should be stopped at the 44. That would be good for 7 yards.
He didn't have a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. On third and short, they'll try
nope.
Option left.
I'll take that. All day.
Behind the line.
Nice.
The punt away whistles as we've come to the end. The third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Okay.
Here comes the Bears punter now. As they come on to kick this one away. Taking it about the 16. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over.
That punt was near perfection as it chipped up inside the 5-yard line. You never know where these things are going to go, do you?
No, what was it? You got a John Heisman quote about that.
Yeah,
right?
He said the football is roughly a prolate spheroid, which means it's going to bounce funny, and you never know where it's going to end up.
They needed some breathing room. He gave it to him. 11 yards and a first down. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here. Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tackle
no.
Mastodon. Oh. Say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep them keep their offense on the sidelines. And let's close this one out.
And they're going to speed things up here. Now Samuel.
Come on, dude.
Oh. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Here's Samuel.
Oh, I think I got it.
Nice. He will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. One after here coming up. This one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. A drive there of just four plays. And the finishing touch was that nice long run into the end zone. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing.
There we go.
But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing and partner. They do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
And the ball is knocked out. And the defense will get their hands on it, going the other way.
South.
And I don't know that that fumble's going to matter. You can look at the deficit here in the fourth. It doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point. But being sloppy throughout the game, not going to help them improve.
This is Samuel. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Tossing it out right for Samuel.
Dang.
They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. So a 5-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to 2nd and 15. They'll keep it on the ground.
Nope.
Samuel. And some room to run now. And he's free going down the left side. Oof. It's a foot race. And they're going to score. Down as they just add to their totals. Well, I'm just not sure what more we can say about him after that one.
But we're certainly going to give it a try, aren't we? Because I believe we're watching greatness personified. It has not mattered all game long where they've handed him the football. He's taken it and found the end zone. He's so locked into that so-called zone, I don't think they're going to get him out of it in this one.
I'm not even sure of the numbers.
Extra point splits the uprights. This one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. And a long run there in the end to top it off. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going.
Exactly.
Yeah, two timeouts. Let's get the ball back.
Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it. Because
you're not going to want that feeling.
You don't want that feeling again. And who may meet up with his team again.
Here's Brown on third down. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted.
Nice.
Another great play defensively. They've been sharp on both sides of the ball, Charles, but that interception means that this defense can very well keep them down to single digits on the scoreboard in this game.
And that's certainly something to smile about, isn't it, partner? You're on defense because your goal every game is to pitch a shutout. But you and I both know that's pretty unrealistic. But to hold a team below double figures in a game, in an NFL game, that's certainly something to take pride in.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
Nice, there it is. 10 tutties for him.
It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
It's over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes, and that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Extra point right down. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a squibber picked up, and he loses
your
the
kid.
The second time. It's going the other way. And that one is his second fumble loss. Not a good look out of your return man.
And not only does he hurt the momentum for his team or even change momentum of the game, but now they've got a decision to make on his own sideline. Does he continue to do that? Do you keep him in that role, or do you bring someone else in at this time?
Man, they just took a timeout with 2 seconds to go.
Yep, I sure did.
Decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. They probably don't need to run a play here, but you want. And he takes it in for the score.
I had to.
Final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome. A little whipped cream on top to the ramble.
As our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little land, yeah, a little extra on top.
Well, fans usually love to see scoring.
I didn't throw once. 24 carries for 658 yards. Let's see what that gets us. I know a lot of that stuff is rushing. Okay. Whoa. Got a lot. 10,000 coins. Token pack. We got three of them. I think I have enough to actually make a set. A future rookie premier set. Gotcha. Okay. Ooh, we can update the opponents too. Oh. Dang, alright. So, I need a new stadium. Right? stadium. Ugh. It's always the chunky soup one. 49ers. What's the most expensive one? Steelers.
Jags, Raiders, Niners, Colts. Cleveland. It's a shame they don't offer the international stadiums. I mean, I like the Rams stadium a lot. It's freaking SoFi. But I'd rather pay a little more and have the Chargers logo. Yeah. And we will make this our base stadium. Give me my Jets jersey back. These things suck. What is this? Really? I have no idea what this is. Oh, you get two picks. Okay. Ooh. Oh, they're all going to be 98 overalls. Oh, my. I already got the Cameron Good. What is our center right now? So I can take him. What a right tackle. 97. Boy, a 98 Devin Lloyd is interesting. Whatever that was. on left guard. So we're technically upgrading any way we look at it. I could just straight up sell this. I'm just straight up sell that Dawson Knox. Actually, no, I'm going to save it. Because this 99 overall is going to go away eventually. Oh, he's our fullback now. I like that. Something going on. A lot of weeboos out there. Okay. Then I know we have to change our slot receiver. I think I'm good for now. I'll be back tonight. We'll do more of this.